What up? It's the Trooper, and it's Tuesday. Matter if it's Tuesday, you ask? It doesn't. I'm just fucking saying it. I got nothing else to say. So yesterday, on Monday, I sort of checked out. I checked out of like my normal everyday life type shit. I went and hung out with a friend and just sort of like, it was awesome. I had like an amazing, relaxing time of like not thinking about the shit that I think about every single day. Yesterday was so good. I was just so like chilled the fuck out and like enjoying the fact that I'm alive. I mean, I enjoy every day. Don't get me wrong. I like my life. I'm here because this is what I want to be doing. You know what I mean? But like sometimes it's fun to just like check out totally. And I don't always do that. Even if I stay home and don't go play poker and don't make a vlog, I'm still not checked out. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, back to the point. Today, I'm gonna do mail time. I was just gonna record mail time when I woke up today and edit it, put it up, and then go out and do my normal thing, find a poker game and like do my shit. But there's more packages at the mailbox. So I'm gonna run out, get the mail right quick, then come back and do one big mail time. It's gonna fucking take forever, but I'm not complaining. I'm just saying it's 3:45 already. So let's go. It's kind of chilly out here, and you know I like it. Where we at? Where my car? Where's my damn, there it is. Trooper Mobile located. What? I'm trying to hurry because I want to get back and record mail time before the sun goes down. Really, I do. I just think mail time's better when there's daylight. You know what I'm saying? Let's go. You know what we need? Another State of the Trooper address. That's what we need. Where I am, why I'm here, how things are going, how they relate to what I expected. Shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Deep shit. Deep, meaningful shit. Sorry, why am I yelling? Damn it, pain in the ass. I gotta get gas. Oh, that shit rhymed. Okay. Yeah, because I like to keep up with the mail time and like, I knew I had two packages here. Like, I don't want to do a mail time and leave two packages here because then they got to wait till the next mail time. And like, I'm just saying, like, I want to get everything in there. So I came over here to get the two packages. You know what I'm talking about? Yo, Trooper, calm the fuck down. Trooper, you guys are crazy. I said package. Calm down. How you doing? I didn't do shit. Great. Ah, damn, I didn't pre-open this shit. It is hot as shit in here. I'm not gonna lie. Yo, sup though? How's it going? How are you today? Let's leave it off. Bitch, open a window. Son of a bitch. F that. Okay, this mail time is starting off with a hitch. No, the fuck is going on? Shit's impossible as fuck. All right, I thought I had the bitch open, but I guess I didn't. All right, so maybe I did have it open. I'm fucking up. Oh shit, okay, hold on. I got it. This mail time's gonna be long as fuck. What the fuck? I still can't get into it. Yeah, kill him. Kill him all. Kill him. Kill them all. Get them bitches. What the fuck is this? Oh, that's just packaging. Get on the shit. I'm not really stupid. What the fuck is happening to my life right now? Focus, bitch. Thank you. What the fuck is the fucking date on? This camera will not pull fucking focus. Blah, 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 blah. Yo, I want to just tell you guys something real quick. First of all, I'm late as fuck today, and it's 7:30 p.m., and I'm editing the mail time. I suck so bad, but I just had to stop working because I got super inspired. I'll tell you about that later, but let me tell you something. I have to show you guys this right now. So PokerKraut just sent me a message on Facebook Messenger, and it's the funniest fucking thing ever. I have to show you. Check this out. So it says, how is your diet going, right? And then there's a picture of him. This is current right now. He's sitting at, that looks like, I don't know if that's Binion's or where, but that's fucking like, look at all that bread. And like, I don't know what that is. It looks like ribs and chicken. Yeah, it looks like ribs and chicken. And then, oh, wait a minute, hold on. All right, he must be at some barbecue joint. What the fuck is this guy doing? That is funny. That is fucking funny. I'm sorry, I just had to show you that. This shit is funny. It's hilarious. Yo, I'm gonna refill this coffee and get back to work on this vlog. I gotta get the fuck out of here. I just got super inspired. And I'll tell you guys about it later. Right now, I gotta work. This goofy-ass old dude in the men's room just now as I was walking towards the door. I was working on zipping my hoodie, and he's like, you need help? Right there, fucking freak. And I'm like, I can't imagine I would need help. And he was like, well, I would have helped you. And I was like, fucking pass. What the fuck? Yo, I'm gonna grab a quick coffee from Starbucks, and then I want to tell you guys about something. So I just want to tell you guys how I got a little inspired earlier. I was actually editing the mealtime video or whatever. And I got a message from someone, and I just sort of like, I guess sometimes there's, I don't know, I sent a tweet that said that something about inspiration is a gift that can come out of nowhere at any second. Respect it with action, and don't let it go to waste. I guess the point is that, like, basically there's this creator of, whose content that I really respect and like. I actually like it a lot. And he sent me a message earlier, and in the message he revealed something about himself to me that really just sort of like, it was touching, but it was really kind of like heartbreaking and inspirational all at the same time. I don't know, it's just that this person is an artist and a creator, and his creations are made, you know, on a computer, just like, you know, someone that makes music or someone that makes videos or someone that makes art, you know, graphic art or whatever. But I found out that this person, like, I had no idea, but I found out that this person has a physical condition. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter. This person's quadriplegic. And, like, I had no idea. And when they told me that, it just sort of, like, made me stop everything and just, like, look at his work, you know? His content that he created. And, you know, he told me that, you know, he has to use a stylus or whatever. Sometimes you see something or learn something that really makes you step back and understand and realize that you really do take things for granted. We all do. And like, nobody's life is without struggle, but, you know, life is not fair. I mean, it's not fair. That's been a constant theme in this vlog. I wish that fucking street rap bullshit wasn't going on over there. It's ruining the fucking mood of the story. I guess the point is, like I was saying, it was sort of like heartbreaking or heart-wrenching or whatever, and inspirational at the same time. And really the focus is the inspiration part of it. It's just crazy to me that this person's creations, this person's art is so good, and you know, the struggle to actually do the physical work of making it, because like he said, it takes him like 10 times longer than it should because he has to use a stylus and he can't do it like by, you know, the methods that anyone else would be able to do it. It's just like super inspirational, man. I don't know, it's just amazing. And it inspires me to look at myself and say, man, you know, I make excuses why I can't go to the gym. I make excuses why I don't want to do this or do that sometimes. And it's just like, My excuses are inexcusable. So I'm just saying, I want that dude to know that his message was super inspirational to me, and like, I don't know. I don't really know what else to say about it. It's hard for me to really tell you what I think about it. I don't really know how to put it into the correct words. But I will tell you this, it's freezing out here, and I'm gonna go inside. Holy shit. Creative works, it's content. And I don't think this guy... So I guess like, it was such an inspirational message, and I wanna share the inspirational message with you guys. I guess the takeaway at the end of the day is this: it doesn't matter who you are or what's happened to you or what hand life dealt you, if you want something and you want to create something, you can. And just remember that whatever your struggles are, nothing is insurmountable. And like, I don't know, I bitch and complain about my struggles, and then I see somebody who struggles so hard to do, like, I don't know. I'm done. You know what I'm saying, though. I mean, I don't know. I hope you get my point. Yo, so it is 4:38. What? 4:38 in the morning right now. And I didn't play poker tonight. So I came down to the strip, and I knew I was going to meet a friend. And you know, fucking loud-ass speakers. And I just decided to hang out with this friend all night long. So we did. We hung out. We got some burgers. Yeah, I said it. Burgers. Weight loss challenge. Did you see the picture I showed you of Poker Crouch? Dudes over there eating ribs and fucking giant loaf of bread and shit. So, holy fucking shit. There's a fucking rat right there. First of all, I didn't even know we had rats in Vegas. What the fuck? I missed him on the camera because he ran so fast, but he was chilling right there. And then when I saw him, he stopped for a second and then he darted into the bushes. Fucking gross, man. From right out here on the street in front of the Venetian at 4:48 in the morning. Please let me remind you that if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the video so they can watch them too, and leave a comment down below. And let's not get squished in this crosswalk. Hey, I don't know what to tell you. Enjoy life, man. I'll see you next time.